As of February 11th of 2024, there are currently 45 volcanoes actively erupting around the planet, including at least one volcano on each continent. Here is a brief overview of one such erupting volcano from each continent. And now, I present this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Hawaii, the Kilauea volcano nearly produced a major flank eruption around February 2nd, only for magma to stall at fairly shallow depths below the surface, which left behind numerous large surface cracks. Meanwhile, in Iceland, a 31-hour-long eruption of the Reykjanes volcano occurred, destroying a section of pipe which supplies hot water and geothermal heating to 30,000 residents. And on the southern flank of the Mauna Loa volcano, a fairly large magnitude 5.7 earthquake struck on February 9th, leading some people to suggest it was volcanic in origin. But was it? The short answer is no, and despite the strong shaking the quake created, it was too weak to hypothetically trigger any magma movement at either the Mauna Loa or Kilauea volcanoes. This quake caused only minimal damage, throwing items off of shelves and onto the floor, largely because of its depth of 23 miles or 37 kilometers. Such a depth places the quake in the upper mantle, indicating that it did not have a magmatic origin, but was rather an example of lithospheric flexure. These quakes occur due to the fact that Earth's crust is floating on top of the mantle. The thicker the crust is, the more it sinks into the planet's interior. Since a big island has been increasing its mass and thickness through volcanic eruptions, it is subsiding at a rate of approximately 1 inch a year. This causes extensional and compressional stress, which can then generate large magnitude earthquakes such as the magnitude 5.7 which just occurred at a depth of greater than 12 miles. Sticking with Hawaii, but moving to the east-northeast, the Kilauea volcano experienced a major shallow magmatic intrusion, which was so close at one point to producing its first southwest rift zone eruption in 50 years. The uptick in activity began at around 3:08 a.m. local time on January 31st when a strong earthquake swarm began at Kilauea's summit region. This earthquake swarm was fairly strong, but more importantly, occurred at very shallow depths of 1 to 2 kilometers, indicating an origin due to the movement of magma. Over the next 60 hours, 30 million cubic meters of magma migrated to shallow depths in the southwest rift zone, causing increasingly southwestward trending earthquakes. Yet, after uplifting the ground by as much as 8 inches, the intrusion stalled out later in the day on February 2nd, and no volcanic eruption ended up occurring. However, it did leave behind large cracks in the ground, which were somewhat similar in appearance to what Iceland's town of Grindavik experienced on November 10th of 2023. Earthquakes have continued to decrease since February 2nd, but the large movement of the failed magmatic intrusion suggests an increased likelihood of a successful eruption occurring the next time magma is sent into the southwest rift zone. In Iceland, the third volcanic eruption in 3 months occurred at the Reykjanes volcano, causing an evacuation of the Blue Lagoon and sending numerous lava fountains up to 200 meters high into the air. The eruption began at 6:02 a.m. local time on February 8, 2024, initially erupting at an incredible rate of 1,000 cubic meters per second. A 2,800-meter-long fissure quickly unzipped in both directions, with lava subsequently flowing towards the Svartsengi geothermal power plant. Over the next 31 hours, several kilometers worth of roads were covered in lava, but most importantly, lava destroyed a 344-meter-long segment of a major geothermal pipe. As a result, 30,000 people lost not only hot water temporarily, but also their main source of building heat in the region. Luckily, this eruption ended 31 hours later, covering about 4.2 square kilometers and 22 million cubic meters of molten rock. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on February 10th of 2024. I would also like to thank my patron, iChickenedOutBill68, for increasing their membership tier to this channel.